Well, I figure I might as well get a shot of these now. This is the washer and dryer I got from my mother's house here. And of course you can see this is a very spacious laundry closet. The problem is the way they designed this house, maybe they had stackable in here at one time or something. You see this door? It's a standard, it's a 24 inch. Mama had a good Kenmore washer and dryer. It was an older model from the 80s, but it was fine. Before the door was put in with the framing and everything, with just the studs in the wall, wouldn't fit in here. So I had to measure and go through spec sheets. Now this was in 2010. And I ordered this set of GE washer and dryer. And I'll be honest with you, it's the only thing that's ever had to do to it is the knobs. In fact, it's the timer knob is broken twice on this machine. That's why there's a little felt dot on here, because we put it over here, and that was to tell where the heck it was on the in the scale, but. Mechanical timer still. Take a look, because we're selling the house, so I mean this, and this is going to stay because the only way it'll come out of here is in pieces. I just wanted to get a record of this because this has been, I mean, it's given us no trouble except for that knob, so. Let's see. Let's see the model number there. I'll look up what all of that means later. Made in Canada. Made in Canada. Well, it's got a light in the dryer here, which I got the flash on here. It's got a light in the dryer. Need to clean the trap real good, but. And these things saw a fair amount of use for, I mean, we were here 3 years when I was rebuilding the other house that we're in now. And then my brother was alive before that here with her, so I mean, he saw a fair amount of use. And this one says Appliance Park, doesn't say made in Canada. Got a quick start guide. Just got the load size, the temperatures, all the rinses are cold, and then the cycles here. 11 cycles, 2 wash spin speed combinations, whatever. You know, these machines really have been fantastic. And I guess this is the last time I'm running them, because cleaning out the house. Yeah, this, I'm pretty sure it was always on the dryer one. I don't think the knob on the washer timer ever broke, but with this one it broke one time. I got a factory GE replacement, and then it cracks on the shaft, and I bought a repro. This was off of Amazon or eBay, I can't remember. But this is an aftermarket replacement, and they actually placed, you can see, the metal band around this to reinforce it, because that's where they always crack and fail. And it was really no more expensive than the GE part. So, and I think I replaced that about a year and a half ago. Yeah, I don't think this thing is going to run with the lid open because of the safety switch, and I'm not about to take it apart and disable all of that, but yeah, she's been a pretty good, pretty good set. If anybody finds these out there in the wild, used secondhand for cheap, they've been very, very reliable. I put the model numbers in the stuff there. Whatever. Here's just a peek of what I've been doing all day. Emptying closets full of cabinets full of linens and pillows, and there's a whole stack in the other room, but these things are pretty handy for saving space. I ought to do a video on this piece of crap. Mother would never let me replace this thing with something better for some reason. It's a piece of junk. Ooh. Pretty. My whole afternoon. Oh well, just wanted to show you all the old washer set. And I'll take a movie of this place before we leave, but yeah, it's a shame. It's a good house, but anyway.